Hi students, good morning and welcome to the new episode of our English class. Then, in the previous class, we discussed about the third chapter. Our third lesson is strength versus size. What is the words? Strength versus size. Strength is spelling S-T-R-E-N-G-T-H. Strength versus B-S. Size, S-I-Z-E, size, strength versus size. I will read the first part once more. Shere Khan, the king of the jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Now the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder and then to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. It was Mungu, the naughty mouse. "Please, please, Shere Khan Uncle, I'm sorry. Let me go. I will help you someday," he pleaded. "Ha ha ha," Shere Khan roared. "How can a little mouse help me?" Shere Khan wanted to sleep, so he let go Mungu off, warning him not to trouble him again. Thank you, Uncle," exclaimed Mungu, jumping with joy. This much we learned in the previous class. Okay, what was the story? Who was Shere Khan? Shere Khan was the king of jungle. What is jungle? Jungle means forest. What do you mean by jungle? Jungle means forest. Here, Shere Khan is a lion and he was the king of forest. Lion was the king of forest. And here, Shere Khan was sleeping. Nap. Nap means a short sleep in the afternoon. It is known as nap. Nap. After lunch, we are having a nap. Like that. Here, Shere Khan, the king of jungle, jungle means forest, is sleeping and he is having a delicious meal. He is having a delicious meal and after that he is having a nap. At that time, he felt something moving from his back. Moving him from his neck to the shoulder and then move on to the back. Then he raised his paw. Paw means this part of the hand is known as paw. P-A-W. With his paw, he searched for something and he felt something soft and wriggly. Wriggly means like moving this position is wriggly. It is moving, it is wriggling and it is very soft. He felt something soft and wriggly. He took it in front of him and closed his eyes and Shere Khan examined it. What was it? What was moving and tickling Shere Khan? It was a rat. It was a rat. R-A-T, rat. The name of the rat was Mungu. M-A-N-K-U, Mungu. And on seeing the lion, Mungu pleaded. Mungu was a naughty rat. N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty. Naughty means naughty, mischievous. Naughty means mischievous. Vigridhyaya. Mungu was a mischievous or naughty rat and he pleaded the lion. Shere Khan Uncle, please let me go. Uncle, please let me go. He pleaded. Who pleaded? Pleaded means asked in a humble, he made a humble request. Pleaded means requested humbly. Shere Khan Uncle, please let me go. I am sorry. Please let me go. I will help you someday. Whenever you are in need, I will help you. Whenever you are in need, I will help you. Who told these words? The rat told these words. What was the name of the rat? Mungu is the rat. And Shere Khan wanted to sleep. Shere Khan wanted to sleep. Shere Khan wanted to sleep. And so Shere Khan roared, "How can a little mouse help me? How can a little mouse like you help me in an adverse situation?" Shere Khan wanted to sleep. So Shere Khan is urgently in need of a sleep because he had a delicious meal. After having delicious meal, his stomach is very full. So he wanted to sleep once more. So he allowed Mungu to go away from there by giving a warning. He warned Shatrughan, warned the Mangu that don't tickle me anymore, don't make me any trouble anymore. Then I am letting you go because I wanted to sleep. This must be studied in the previous class. Okay, let us look at the tough word from the previous class. Shere Khan. Listen here. S H E R K H A N. Shere Khan. Speak with me. Say the word loudly with me. S H E R K H A N. Shere Khan. Next word is Jungle. J U N G L E. Jungle. It is the next word. Jungle. What is the meaning of jungle? Forest. Jungle means forest. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle meaning forest. F-O-R-E-S-T. Forest. The next word is delicious. D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. Delicious. Say with me. D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. Delicious. What is the meaning of delicious? Tasty. Delicious means tasty. Next word is tickling. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G. Tickling. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G. Tickling means tickly after tickling. Tickling, tickling. Then sensation. S-E-N. Say with me. S-E-N. S-A-T-I-O-N. How do we read this word? Sensation. S-E-N. S-A-T-I-O-N. Sensation. Then next one. Shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D. Shrugged. Which is the word? Shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D. Shrugged means what? Shrugged is shoulders. Like this. We are shrugging our shoulders. S-H-O. Listen here. S-H-O. U-L-D-E-R-S. Shoulders. S-H-O-U-L-D-E-R-S. Shoulders. Next word is wriggly. W-R-I-G-G-L-Y. Wriggly. How do we read this word? Wriggly. W-R-I-G-G-L-Y. Wriggly. Next word. Pleaded. P-L-E-A-D-E-D. Pleaded. P-L-E-A-D-E-D. Pleaded means requested humbly. Pleaded. Pleaded. Next word is warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Warning. Next word is exclaimed. E-X-C-L-A-I-M-E-D. Exclaimed. Look at the word. E-X-C-L-A-I-M-E-D. Exclaimed. Okay. Are you familiar with these words? I'll read it once more. Shere Khan. Jingle. Delicious. Tickling. Sensation. Shrugged. Shoulders. Wriggly. Pleaded. Warning. Explained. These are the new words from the first portion. Okay, let us move on to the next. Take page number 24. Page number 24. All of you take the text. Listen carefully while I am reading. A week later, Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. That is Uncle Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Mangu, don't go. He will eat you, said Tingu. Who asked, said this? Mangu, don't go. He will eat you, said Tingu. Mangu did not listen. Mangu went and saw that Shere Khan was trapped in a net. He was struggling and angry. A week later means this incident happened and the lion Shere Khan let Mangu go away from there, and Mangu was not there, and Shere Khan lived in the jungle. Like every day, one day while Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friend. What is he playing? Hide and seek. H I do you know what is hide and seek? H I D hide and seek. Hide and seek. N-D-S-E-E-K. We are playing, you are playing hide and seek in our house, isn't it? Yes, you are playing hide and seek. Here, the rats, Mangu, Tingu and Shangi, who were playing? Mangu, M-A-N-K-U, Mangu. Then, Tingi, Tingu, T-I-N-K-U, Tingu, Mangu, Tingu and Shangi, S-H-A-N. K-Y, Shangi, S-H-A-N-K-Y, Shangi. Who were playing hide and seek? Mangu, Tingu and Shangi. They were rats. They were playing hide and seek. A week later, that means after 1 week. A week later means after 1 week. Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends. Who were the friends of Mangu? Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Loud means louder. That means a sound which is very louder. Louder roar. R-O-A-R. R-O-A-R. They heard a loud, at the time while they were playing hide and seek, they heard a loud sound. Loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened. On hearing the loud roar, Tingu and Shangi, the friends of Mangu, were frightened. Frightened means they were scared. F-R-I-G-H-T-F-R-I-G-H-T-E-N-E-D. Frightened means scared. Frightened means scared. They were cried. They were frightened. Pedichu. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. What did Mangu do? His ears, he has 2 ears, he put it upright to hear the roar clearly. Mangu's ears were upright. U-P-R-I-G-H-T. Upright. U-P-R-I-G-H-T. Upright. But Mangu's ears were upright. That is Uncle Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Mangu says to himself, that is Uncle Shere Khan. Who is that roaring? Uncle Shere Khan. He may be in trouble. T-R-O-U-B-L-E. Trouble. He may be in trouble. He is roaring. He may be in trouble. That is Uncle Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Uncle Shere, on hearing the roaring sound, Mangu realized that it is made by Uncle Shere Khan. Do you understand the point? On hearing the roaring sound, Shangi and Tingu were frightened, but Mangu held his ears upright and he realized that it is from the lion, Uncle Shere Khan, and he may be in trouble. He may be in trouble. I will read that paragraph once more. You please listen. A week later, Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. That is Uncle Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Mangu thought that the sound is coming from Uncle Shere Khan and he seems to be in trouble. He may be in trouble. Okay, let us look at the tough words from this part. Hide and seek. Listen to the spelling. H-I-D-E. Hide and S-E-E-K. See. Hide and see. Next word. Mangu. M-A-N-K-U. Tingu. T-I-N-K-U. And Shangi. S-H-A-N-K-Y. Mangu is the rat we are studying. And Tingu and Shangi are the friends of Mangu. Tingu and Shangi are the friends of Mangu. The next word is roar. R-O-A-R. Roar. Then Mangu is our rat and Tingu and Shangi were the friends of Mangu. Next word is roar. R-O-A-R. Roar. R-O-A-R. Roar means the sound made by lion or roar. Tell the sound made by lion says raw. The next one, frightened, 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 frightened means scared. They became very scared, frightened. The next word is upright, upright, upright means held in the right position, upright, held in a right position. The next word is trouble, trouble, trouble means he is in trouble, he may be in some trouble. Is it clear? I will read that once more, you please listen to the text. A week later, Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends, Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. That is Uncle Sher Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Okay, let us move on to the next part. Mangu, don't go, he will eat you, said Tingu. Tingu is the friend of Mangu, and the rat going near a lion is very dangerous. Rats going near a lion is very dangerous. They will eat the smaller animals. They will eat, if they are hungry, they will eat the smaller animals. Mangu did not listen. Tingu gave a warning to Mangu. Mangu, please don't go near the lion. He will eat you. He will eat you, said Tingu. But Mangu did not listen. The word listen. Please listen. L-I-S-T-E-N. Listen. How do we pronounce it? Listen. T is silent. T is silent. T is not pronounced. Listen. It is L-I-S-T. We are writing this word as listen, but we pronounce this word as listen. It is listen. And Mangu did not listen because he had he is grateful to G-R-A-T-E. If you are grateful means thankful. Mangu is grateful to Sher Khan because one day Sher Khan let him go from there while he is sleeping. While Mangu tickled Sher Khan, he let Mangu go away from there without doing any harm to Mangu. He remembered that, and he is not frightened on hearing the roaring of the lion Sher Khan. He decided to go near the lion. Mangu went and saw that Sher Khan was trapped in a net. Mangu go to the place from where the roaring sound came. Then what did he found? Mangu found that Sher Khan was trapped in a net. T-R-A-P-P-E-D. Trapped. T-R-A-P-P-E-D. Trapped. T-R-A-P-P-E-D. Sher Khan was trapped in a net. Mangu went and saw that Sher Khan was trapped in a net. He was struggling and angry. Sher Khan was struggling to escape. Struggling. S-T-R-U-G-G-L-I-N-G. Struggling. S-T-R-U-G-G-L-I-N-G. Struggling. Sher Khan was struggling to escape. And he was very angry. A-N-G-R-Y. Angry. A-N-G-R-Y, angry. Sher Khan was very angry, and he was struggling to escape from there. What was it? Let us have a look. Mangu went and saw that Sher Khan was trapped in a net. While Mangu reached near the lion, he was trapped in a net. Some hunters trapped Sher Khan. Some hunters, H-U-N-D-E-R-S, hunters means petaka. They trapped the Sher Khan using a net. Sher Khan was trapped in a net. He was struggling and angry. Sher Khan was struggling inside the net to escape. He was going here and there, and he was struggling, and he was very angry. The lion Sher Khan looked so angry because he is struggling to escape. Don't worry, uncle. Don't worry. Do not worry, uncle. Do not worry. Do not worry. W-O-R-R-Y. Worry. W-O-R-R-Y. Worry. Don't worry, uncle. Worry means vishamikiga. Don't worry, uncle. Don't worry. I will cut away the net and free you. He said. Who said these words? Mangu said it to Shere Khan. Don't worry, Uncle. Don't worry. I will cut away the net. I can cut the net using my teeth. I can cut the net using my teeth. You don't worry. You stay there without any fear. You don't worry, Uncle. I will cut away the net and free you and let you free. He said. He started to nibble the net. What did he do? Mangu started. S-T-A-R-T-E-D. Started. S-T-A-R-T-E-D. He started to nibble. N-I-B-B-L-E. N-I-B-B-L-E. He started to nibble the net. He started to nibble. Nibble means nibbling. What is Rat doing? Karandu dinuka. Nibble. He is going to, he started, tackle means begin. He started to nibble the net. He started to nibble the net. In a short while, that means within a few minutes, in a short while, within a few minutes, he had cut enough for Shere Khan to escape. Enough. E-N-O-U-G-H. E-N-O-U-G-H. He has cut enough. Enough place for Shere Khan to escape. Did he cut all the net? No, he don't cut all the net, but he cut enough. He made enough space. Enough means act. He cut enough space and enough space for Shere Khan to escape from the net. Escape. E S C A P E. Escape. E S C A P-E. Escape means go away from there, escape from the hunters. Okay, these are the tough words from the last part. Which are the words? Listen, L-I-S-T-E-N, listen. Say the word loudly, L-I-S-T-E-N, listen. Then next one is trapped, T-R-A-P-P-E-D, trapped. Next word is struggling, S-T-R-U-G-G. L-I-N-G, struggling. Next word, angry. A-N-G-R-Y, angry. Next word is worry. W-O-R-R-Y, worry. W-O-R-R-Y, worry. Next word, started. S-T-A-R-T-E-D, started. S-T-A-R-T-E-D, started. Next word is nibble. N-I. E-N-O-U-G-H, enough. Then next word, escape. E-S-C-A-P-E, escape. Okay. Thank you, Mungu. Now I know size has nothing to do with the strength. What did the lion say? Who is the lion? Who is the lion? Shere Khan is the lion. Then what did the lion say? Thank you, Mungu. But at that time, at the first part, we see that when Mangu told the lion that one day I will help you, Mangu promised the lion, promised Shere Khan that one day I will help you, Uncle. Then the lion asked him, how do a small animal like you can help me? How do you help me? I am very big and you are very small. Then how can you help me? How can you help me? Then now the lion realized that, the lion understood that size or strength is not the matter. Thank you, Mangu. Now I know size has nothing to do with the strength. Size, S-I-S-A-D, size, S-I-S-A-D, size has nothing to do with the strength. Size has nothing to do with the strength. I am a big sized animal, but I was in the net for a long time and I was struggling inside the net to escape from there, but I couldn't. But when a small animal like you, he came to me and you cut or nibbled the net and you made me escape from there. And now I understood that, and now I realized that size has nothing to do with the strength. Size has nothing to do with the strength. Do with the strength, said Shere Khan as he walked away. He walked away, go away from there. Walked away. W-A-L-K. KED walked away. Walked away means go away from there. He went away from there. Okay. He went away from there. Shere Khan on saying the rat Mangu that size has nothing to do with the strength. For size and strength is not related. Size has nothing to do with the strength. A small size rat can made me escape from the net. The small size rat can made me escape from the net. So I am very thankful to you. Now I realize that size has nothing to do with the strength. Size has nothing to do with the strength. Let us listen to the new words. Listen, L-I-S-T-E-N, listen. Then trapped, T-R-A-P-P-E-D, trapped. Struggling, S-T-R-U-G-G-L-I-N-G, struggling. Then the next word is angry, A-N-G-R-Y, angry. Worry, W-O-R-R-Y, worry. Then started, S-T-A-R-T-E-D, started. Nibble, N-I-B-B-L-E, nibble. Enough, E-N-O-U-G-H, enough. Escape, E-S-C-A-P-E, escape. And size, S-I-Z-D, size. Walk the way, W-A-L-K-E-D, A-W-A-L. Okay, I'll read the second part once more. You please listen to the text. A week later, Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends, Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. That is humble Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Mangu did not go. Mangu, don't go. He will eat you, said Tingu. Mangu did not listen. Mangu went and saw that Shere Khan was trapped in a net. He was struggling and angry. Who was struggling and angry? Shere Khan was struggling and angry. Don't worry, uncle. I will cut away the net and see you, he said. Who said these words? Mangu said this word. What were the words? Do not worry, uncle. I will cut away the net and free you. He started to nibble the net. Mangu started to nibble the net. In a short while, that means within a few seconds, he had cut enough for Sheikh Shere Khan to escape. He had cut enough to for the lion to escape. Thank you, Mangu. Now I know size has nothing to do with the strength. Now I know size has nothing to do with the strength, said Shere Khan as he walked away. Okay. I'll read the text, full chapter once more. You please listen to the text. Shere Khan, the king of the jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He tickled his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Now the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder and then on to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. It was Mangu, the naughty mouse. Mangu was a naughty mouse. Please, Shere Khan uncle, I'm sorry, let me go. I will help you someday, he pleaded. Who pleaded? Mangu pleaded. Ha ha ha, Shere Khan roared. How can a little mouse help me? How can a little mouse help me? Shere Khan wanted to sleep, so he let go Mangu off, warning him not to trouble him again. Thank you, uncle, exclaimed Mangu, jumping with joy. A week later, Mangu was playing hide and seek with his friends, Tingu and Shangi. They heard a loud roar. Tingu and Shangi were frightened, but Mangu's ears were upright. That is Angul Shere Khan. He seems to be in trouble. Mangu, don't go. He will eat you, said Tingu. Mangu did not listen. Mangu went and saw that Shere Khan was trapped in a net. He was struggling and angry. Do not worry, Angul. I will cut away the net and free you, he said. He started to nibble the net. In a short while, he had cut enough for Shere Khan to escape. Thank you, Mangu. Now I know size has nothing to do with the strength, said Shere Khan as he walked away. Okay, our lesson is complete, and the thing you have to do is read the lesson as many times as possible, not 2 times, 3 times or 4 times. Whenever you get time, you ask your parent to sit with you and you read the text very carefully and write down the tough words 10 times in your rough book. Write down the tough words 10 times in your rough book and read the lesson. It is very important reading the text reading is very important, and that will help you to answer the questions. And after two chapters are over, and the second chapter's note will come to you. And after finishing the notes, you will send me the notes in WhatsApp. And after that, we have to conduct a test paper. We will conduct a test paper in the next week. Okay, study well and be prepared with the lessons. Wish you all the best. Thank you.